Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another awesome Tinkercad tutorial. So let's get cracking. Friends, today's new project is going to be Codeblocks. I always choose sign in with Google, and then we're going to click create and Codeblocks. Friends, when you build with Codeblocks, we make something called a template. So right now I'm going to create a template called the leg, because the object we're going to make is a table, and tables have legs. So we're going to build our table with legs out of the shape of a box. When you bring out the box, we drop it inside, and then we change its measurements. I'm going to tell you the numbers we want are 5x5, and I'm going to tell you a height of 35 is good. So this defined the leg. This is where the leg gets used. If we hit play, bingo, that's our table leg. Now they line up at 0, 0, so you can see half of the leg is up and half of the leg is below 0. We'll play with that in a bit. Right now I'm going to throw this away until I want to use it. So the next time I hit play, the leg is available, but it's not on the screen. Now let's return to templates, and this time we're going to create the top of the table. Once again, they give us the template top piece. I'll move it up here. And they give us the part where it actually draws, and I'll leave that there for a moment. Now, most tables are round or made out of squares or rectangles. I'm going to build with the box. Once again, we drop it in and we pick our measurements. You can pick whatever you want. I'm going to choose 30. I'm going to choose a length of 45. And then I want it to be only 5 thick. I am going to give this a edge of 2, and I want it to have steps of 2. When we hit play now, you will see our table draw, and you can see that's our tabletop. Once again, it goes at 0, 0, so you can see half of it above, and half of it is below the work plane. Once again, if we throw this away and hit play, nothing shows up, because we've got things defined, but we're not using them. Friends, now that we've got our pieces, we're going to actually build. If you go to templates, let's start by bringing out the top. Simply move a command out, and we can move it in X, Y, and Z. The only place I want to move it is Z. Remember how we made our legs 35 high? I'm going to move my table to 35, so it should land on top. Let's hit play and watch our table draw and move to the location it needs to be. If you hold down shift and right click drag, you can pan, so that way this is in the middle. You can also zoom in, zoom out, and just use the view cube to check it out from every location you want. I like to right click drag. Now let's return to our templates and bring out a leg. When we first hit play with this, you can see the tabletop comes up and the leg is down below. Friends, we need to raise this up, and we're going to do it with a math block. Find the one that has 0 plus 0, and when you bring it out, we need to put the left edge of it in the Z hole. Notice if you try and do the right edge, it goes over an X, and I saw that a lot in my classrooms, so make sure it's the left edge in the box. And then we need to change it to division, because we're going to take the height of that leg, 35, and we're going to divide it by 2. Now when we hit play, bingo, our leg is at the exact right height. How cool is that? Now remember, we did 30 and 45, so we're going to take those in halves and go a little bit less, because we've got a plan for the size of these legs. So I'm just going to type 10, and I'm going to type less than half of this. I'm going to try 20 and hit play. Check it out, that leg is out there and it's pretty darn cool. Instead of 10 and 20, I'm gonna do 10 and 18, because notice how that sticks out just a little past. Now it's absolutely perfect. I'm also gonna take the color of my leg and I'm gonna make it light brown. Check that out. Now friends, this is where it gets magical. We can right click duplicate. Make sure you're on the blue one when you do that, so that way you get both pieces. And if we change this X to -10 and hit play, bingo, two legs. Now once again, return up here to the blue create leg. We want to duplicate both chunks, and we can finish this project up by simply changing both of the Y's to the negative. So there's negative 18 for the front leg, negative 18 for the back leg. I'm gonna also make my tabletop a dark brown. Friends, check it out. You hit play and you have got an awesome table. How cool is that? Now friends, you can do all kinds of adjustments. Let's say you want your legs to be 4x4. Simply change the numbers and hit play. Boom, it instantly adjusts. Say you want your edges to be something different. Let's say you want it to be really smooth, so you make it 10. Bang, all of a sudden you have got rounded edges on your table. So many ways that you can use your code to make your table look exactly how you want. Now friends, I do want to remind you, down here there are legacy pieces of code. If you look up any of my older tutorials, you'll see that I used create new object. That is how we used to build. Now instead of create new object, we simply use create template. The bonus of that is the templates do not have to be deleted, and we used to have to delete the objects back in the day. Friends, as you finish, make sure you name it. Simply click up here and give it a name. I'm going to call mine table. I also want to use this in the default editor. Let me show you how to do that. Simply click up on export, and we are going to choose a shape. If you wanted to 3D print it, you could use these. You could also laser cut it, but once again, we are going to create a shape. When it pops up, you will see an image of what you made. Give it a name. I'm going to call it a table. You can give it a description. I am going to give it a tag of table. I'm also going to type rectangle and press enter, so that way I know which kind of table it is. I never lock the part size, and finally click save shape. Later, when you're in the normal Tinkercad editor, you will have that table available to be used. Finally, friends, click back on this workspace and you will see your cool little table show up. Friends, if you want to show the world what you built, you simply click on properties. Make sure it has a name. You can give it a description. Notice my descriptions always have the tutorial. This one I'm making right now, so it says coming soon. There is also more information about how you can find me on YouTube and my website. Down here we have tags. Make sure you put the tags about what you made. I've got a table, and then friends, if you type the tag HLMT23, I search that tag almost every day, and when I find your designs, I will give you a reaction. Finally, make it public, and then I always choose attribution, no derivatives, because I want you to come up here, find the tutorial, and learn some epic skills. When you're done, hit save changes. The next thing is that you can go to the gallery, friends. When you do, the first thing you'll see are all the awesome staff picks. You can check them out in circuits. Notice you can find HLModTech there, and then also in Codeblocks. Now, as fun as the staff picks are, I love to shut that off, because check it out, you will see your awesome design and the designs of others. Now friends, when you click on these, if you think they're awesome, make sure you click on them and give them a reaction. Of course, when you click on mine, reactions are also appreciated. Don't forget, you'll also find those tutorials in the links. Finally, friends, if you click on the HLModTech name, you will be able to see all of my 3D designs sorted by likes. Notice almost all of them have that tutorial, and reactions are appreciated. Friends, if you want to find the Codeblocks ones, they are right here. Of course, friends, every design you click on will have a tutorial, and reactions are appreciated. Friends, I do want to quickly remind you about my website, HLModTech.com. I've got the page dedicated to Tinkercad, tons of amazing categories, and then also day one lessons, useful starters, and Tinkercad essentials. Friends, there is also the sweet built-in messaging tool. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. I do also want to highlight the link to the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, we've got more than 700 members, and it is a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HLModTech. Of course, friends, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.